The Creator, a science fiction film set in the not-too-distant future, directed by Gareth Edwards, who previously brought us the Star Wars film Rogue One. This made it a combination too hard for me to resist. So what could possibly go wrong? This one was shot with an aspect ratio of 2.78 to 1, so in that regard, it's like going back to the early 1950s and those glorious days when Cinerama was introduced and then CinemaScope, and we had very wide images on huge screens. So a modern film with the latest camera equipment, all the current technology, and it's probably one of the most disappointing, if not the most disappointing, 4K discs I've yet purchased. Now, there are reasons for this, and I think it's my initial disappointment at how this looks, but I do think it's a deliberate look they've gone for. They've gone for a grainy, sort of dull, muted look. Possibly the dull, muted look is because of all the CGI throughout. It's just about everywhere. And to make that look real, if you darken the image down and make it a bit hazy, you can get away with things that maybe would have been too obvious that they weren't real. So there's a lot of faux film grain in this. There was a variety of video cameras used, digital video cameras, and I think the main one was a Nikon prosumer camera, and that was put in a sort of a gimbal mount so the director could do the shooting himself, and it is well shot. The faux film grain introduced for this one does look a little fuzzy at times, or at least it does to me, and there are times in low light when I think that fuzz may well be video noise. It suggests to me that the prosumer cameras used to shoot this one were struggling a little in low light, and therefore when it was brought up during the mastering process, they brought the brightness up, it turned some of that into video noise, and there are telltale colours giving that video noise away. But they did use a Kohler scope lens. Now, this is a Kohler scope lens. This is an 8Z, so somewhat earlier scope lens. But that introduces sort of slight fall off at the edges, a sort of blurring that gives the overall picture a more natural look. And I like that about it. That works rather well. I would like to know which scope lens it was they used. This is a 2x anamorphic. And if you can see down there, I might look a little screwy as that goes around, but that's how the squeezing anamorphic process is done. You have the scope lens one way round on the camera, then the other way to project it, and that's how you get a 2x squeeze or a 1.5 squeeze, or indeed a 1.25 squeeze. I did play with the settings on both my video projector and the 4K player to squeeze the most out of the image, and in places it did look very good. The colour was muted for the most part, but realistic, and there are bursts of colour that make you think, oh yes, this is a 4K. So I did my usual at the end of it, put the Blu-ray in, and the 4K is immediately perceptibly superior to the Blu-ray. The Blu-ray is good, but I can see immediately the colours are not right. They're not realistic like they are on the 4K. And that's really what we pay for with a 4K. Now, at 10 feet wide, you can often tell a difference in definition between the 4K and the Blu-ray. I didn't necessarily look for that on this one because it's not the best defined disc I've ever looked at. But I put them both on the telly afterwards, and immediately I'd say everything was more acceptable. It looked better on the telly, and that's, even though it's identical, I could tell it looked identical, it's the size differential. You go from about 3 feet up to 10 feet wide, and that size differential just really tells you everything you need to know. You can see everything clearly, and that's why I've always liked to do a review. Even when I was reviewing Super 8 films, Super 8 releases for magazines or fanzines, I always like to review them on as big a screen as possible, and that's why all these years we've had a 10-foot roll-down screen, which I hope is going to go back into duty in the living room at some point. But it made it easier on a 10-foot screen to immediately, perceptibly tell the difference between even an 8-foot screen or, of course, a 7-foot screen. So the bigger you go, the easier it is to discern a difference from one film or one video disc to another. And that's why I was a little disappointed with this 4K of The Creator. I'm not disappointed with the slipcover though. That's a beauty. It gives you a perception. This is going to be a pristine looking film, and you're going to have a great time with it on your home screen, however big it is. But as I said, I think the next time I watch this, I'll be prepared for that. Won't have the disappointment, and I'll feel it's a much more enjoyable movie as a result. It has Dolby Atmos sound on the 4K disc, and it has DTS 7.1 on the Blu-ray. Both sounded fantastic in here, but of course it's THX 5.1, which is a little different, a bit more like Dolby Atmos than DTS 7.1, I suppose, but very good sound all round. And so there is much to like about this disc, even though I am clearly a little disappointed with the way it looks. John David Washington plays the lead role in this, and he is engaging, just as he was, or just as I found he was, in Tenet. But also Madeline Yuna-Vorse, who plays the young girl robot in this, absolutely brilliant. Now, a lot of it was shot in Asia, Thailand particularly, and for that reason you get a few subtitles, and a bit different the subtitles on this, because normally the subtitles are in the picture area for when you're seeing it in a cinema, and it wouldn't therefore be on the black masking below. But of course in here they were on the black masking, weren't they? So that took some sorting out. I thought, do I put the bottom mask down? Do I just leave as it is and struggle to read what's on the black? In the end, I had to put the bottom mask down in order to read the subtitles. There aren't many, and you do get the gist of the story, even if you can't fully read them every time they come up. Ever since Blade Runner came out in 1982, other science fiction films have done a little to emulate it quite often, and this film is no exception. The cityscapes are clearly lifted off the Blade Runner copybook, so I like that about it. They're not very often on the screen, but when they do appear, even though they haven't got the image quality of the Blade Runner 4K disc, they're very nice to see. The film had an estimated budget of $80 million and grossed at the worldwide box office just $104 million. So perhaps that tells a bit of a story. It has a running time of 2 hours and 13 minutes. I think I would have preferred it if it had been about 15 minutes shorter, but that's just me. See what you think. There is a making of documentary on the Blu-ray, and that runs for almost an hour. Why is it so many people use the word like so often when they're talking? It's poor use of vocabulary and expression, and it does make this documentary, which otherwise I would think I would have found extremely interesting. I found it a little difficult to get all the way through, but if you can get past that, I think it is interesting. It tells you a lot about how the film was made, and there is much to admire about how this one was made. Overall, there is much to appreciate in this release. I just felt that the image was somewhat lackluster. But if you're into science fiction action movies with great sound, plenty of CGI, well filmed and with good acting, then this one may well be for you. I purchased this at the Bristol branch of HMV, which is right in the middle of the shopping centre. I think it's Cabot Circus, it's just by, and right opposite is a branch of CEX for second-hand DVDs, Blu-rays and 4Ks. So a great place to go to if you're ever in the Bristol area. And what a great HMV store, two floors, and the video and music is predominantly upstairs. All sorts of other things in there as well now, but the first floor is pretty cavernous. It's not quite the Leicester branch, but it's a very good place to go into and enjoy if you're into music and particularly video. Quite a big selection of 4K with one complete wall here covered in 4Ks, and let's just have a look at some of the discs that are on sale. And wouldn't you know it, they had two copies of the special edition of the 4K, The Proposition. Now, if I'd have known so many people were going to be interested in that after my last review video went up, I'd have purchased both of those because they were just £19.99. So there you are. If you can get into the Bristol HMV, make a beeline for that and see if you can nab one of those two last copies. So another great branch of HMV, and I very much enjoyed a chat with the manager, learned quite a lot about how well HMV are in general doing. And that's great to hear, and it's also great in here on the comments when people tell me how much they appreciate their local branch of HMV. And well, I think a lot of us now appreciate HMV and being able to go in and actually browse and decide on what you want to buy or save up for to buy in the near future. So maybe I'll be able to bring you a few more HMVs in the months or years ahead, but I'll have to check back through and see if there's any that people have sent me videos they've shot that I haven't featured yet. If I haven't, send me a reminder and I'll get that dealt with in a future video. Anyway, I think that brings us to the end. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a like and perhaps consider subscribing so I'll be encouraged to carry on creating nonsense like this in the future. Until the next video, bye bye for now.